Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I thought it would be fun to do a bunch of different hairstyles using a scrunchie. I recently opened an online store, missysueshop.com, and all of the scrunchies that I'm using in today's video can be found there. I'll leave a link down below in my description box in case you want to check it out. There's a lot of really cute things. If you're new to my channel, make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads, and let's get started! For the first hairstyle, I'm going to divide off a section from my right ear up to my crown and then just clip this out of the way for now. Then I'm going to divide off a similar section on the left side of my head, so starting at my ear and going up to my crown. I'm going to spray this with hairspray and brush through it to remove tangles. And now I'm going to take both sections and twist each one inwards towards the back of my head. Then I'm going to tie the two sections together with a clear elastic band. And now I'm going to flip the ends up and around the elastic so the two sides are more twisted. And then I'm going to make the twists bigger by going back over them and pulling on the edges. And then I'm just going to grab my scrunchie and wrap it over the elastic band to finish off the style. The next style is a low bun. So for this style, I'm going to begin by leaving out some hair to frame my face. And then I'm going to spray the hair with a medium hold hairspray and brush down the top of the hair to smooth down any flyaways and help combine the hair together. Then I'm going to gather all of the hair together at the nape of my neck. And using a hairband, I'm going to begin tying the hair into a low ponytail. On the last wrap of the elastic though, I'm going to pull the hair only partway through so the hair forms a loop, and this is going to be the base of the bun. Then with the ends left sticking out, I'm going to divide these in half and twist them slightly, and I'm going to wrap them across the top of the bun in opposite directions, so the left side goes over to the right and the right side goes across towards the left. And then I'm going to tuck the ends back into the hairband underneath the bun to hold them in place. Now I'm going to go back over the crown of my head and detail the hair a little bit. So I'm going to gently pull on small sections of hair just to create some volume and texture. And then I'm going to grab a super silky scrunchie from my store and wrap it over the bun so it sits at the top of the bun. And then I'm just going to spray the style with hairspray and smooth down the hair at my crown. For the half up double buns, I'm going to have my hair parted towards the left side, and I'm going to divide off some hair to frame my face. Then I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the right side, starting at my right temple and going back to the crown of my head. Then using an elastic, I'm going to wrap this once over the hair, and then on the second wrap, I'm going to pull the hair only a little ways through to create a loop. And then I'm going to take the ends from this section and wrap them around the elastic band a couple times, and then tuck the ends back into the elastic underneath the bun to hold them in place. So now I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the left side of my head, starting at about my temple and going back towards my crown. And I'm going to tie this hair into another little bun. So I'm wrapping an elastic twice over the section, and on the second wrap, I'm pulling the hair partway through to create a loop. Then I'm going to wrap the tail around the elastic band and tuck the ends into the elastic to hold it in place. And then I'm going to grab two scrunchies from my mini scrunchie set and wrap them over each of the buns. The next style is a high bun, so for this one I'm going to brush all of my hair up to the top of the back of my head. I'm also spraying it with hairspray just to smooth down any flyaways and remove any tangles. So then I'm going to use a hairband and tie the hair up into a high ponytail. Then I'm just going to combine all of the hair from the ponytail, twist it together, and wrap it clockwise around the hairband to form a bun. Then I'm just going to tuck the ends of the hair back into the hairband at the back of the bun to hold them in place. And then lastly, I'm going to grab my scrunchie and wrap it over the bun so it sits against my head at the base of the bun. For the third hairstyle, I'm going to start by dividing out two sections of hair on both sides of my head. So I'm going to start the section at about my temples, so there's hair to cover my ears. And I'm also leaving out some hair to frame my face. And I'm going to be bringing these two side sections to the back of my head. Then using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie the two sections together. And now I'm going to create a gap in the hair right above the elastic band. And I'm going to flip the ends of the section around the elastic band so the two sides are twisted. Then I'm going to gently pull on sections of the twists to add some texture and to also make them fuller. And then I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the right side of the twist and a small section on the left side and combine these together above the elastic band. I'm going to tie them together with another elastic band, but on the last wrap of the elastic, I'm going to pull the hair about a third of the way through to create a loop. Then I'm going to wrap the tail around the elastic band and tuck the ends into the elastic to hold it in place. And now I'm going to grab my scrunchie and place it over the bun so it sits underneath the twisted section and right above the little bun. For the sixth hairstyle, I need to divide off the middle section of my hair since I'll be using this for my braid. So starting at the right corner of my forehead, I'm going to create a zigzag part line down the right side of my head, down towards the nape of my neck. So I'm going to divide off the hair at the bottom to use later on. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the left side of my head. So I'm creating a zigzag part line to separate the top hair from the side. And then I'm just going to use a clear elastic to tie off the bottom section to use later. So now with the top section of hair, I'm going to braid this into a Dutch braid. So I'm going to pick up a section near the hairline and divide it into three pieces. With a Dutch braid, I'm going to be crossing the side strands underneath the middle strand. So after the first stitch, I'm going to cross one side under the middle, pick up a new section of hair and cross it under the middle strand as well. And then I'm crossing the other side under the middle, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it under, adding it into the middle strand. And I'm just going to repeat those steps, crossing the side strands under the middle strand while adding new sections of hair into the braid, alternating between the left and right side strands, working my way down my head, bringing in all of the hair from this middle section. As you're braiding, make sure to pull the hair tight against the head so that when you finish, it's not too loose and bumpy in places. It'll be easier to loosen the hair afterwards than to finish the braid and try and make it tighter if it's too loose. So once the braid reaches the nape of my neck, I'm just going to clip off the end of the braid so it doesn't unravel. And now I'm going to gather all of my hair together at the nape of my neck, leaving out the braid for now, and I'm going to brush through the hair to remove any tangles. And then once it's all smooth, I'm going to add in the braid and remove the clip. And then I'm just going to tie it all together at the nape of my neck using a hairband. And then once it's all tied off, I'm going to go back over the braid and carefully pull on the outer edges to make the braid wider so it'll look more full. And then I'm just going to grab my scrunchie and wrap it over the hairband at the base of the braid. Going off the last hairstyle, I'm going to convert my ponytail into a bun. So to do this, I'm going to take one piece of the hairband and pull it down over the ponytail partway to create a loop with the hair. Then, as you guessed it, I'm going to take the ends and split them into two sections. I'm going to wrap these two sections over the top of the bun, one from the left side and one from the right, and then tuck the ends back into the hairband underneath the bun to hold them in place. And then I'm just going to take my velvet pearl scrunchie and wrap it over the bun so it sits at the base of the braid. The next style is another half up, so I'm going to divide off a section of hair at the corners of my forehead and bring it together at the crown of my head. Then using a clear elastic band, I'm going to tie off the hair, but on the last wrap of the elastic, I'm going to pull the hair about a third of the way through to create a loop. Then I'm going to pull on sections of the loop in opposite directions to make it kind of disheveled and messy. And now I'm going to take the ends from the bun, twist them together and wrap them around the elastic band about 3 times. And you can do this more or less depending on the length of your hair. But then I'm just going to tuck the ends into the elastic band to hold it in place. And now I'm going to grab my scrunchie and wrap it over the bun so it's sitting around the bottom of the bun. And then I'm going to grab some bobby pins and pin down any sections of the bun that are sticking out over the scrunchie. The next hairstyle is a quick bubble ponytail. So for this, I'm going to start by dividing off a section of hair at the top of my head and tie it off with a scrunchie. Then I'm going to divide off another section of hair. This one will be from my temples downwards towards the nape of my neck. And I'm going to grab another scrunchie and tie off this section a couple inches below the first scrunchie. Then I'm going to carefully pull on the hair that is in between the two scrunchies to kind of fluff it up so the bubble in the hair shows up better. And now I'm going to take the remaining hair below the other two scrunchies and I'm going to combine it all together a few inches below the second scrunchie, and then grabbing a third scrunchie, I'm going to tie the hair together like before. Then I'm going to go back over the hair between the bottom two scrunchies and just pull on small pieces to add some texture and volume and to make the little bubble in the hair show up better. For the 10th hairstyle, I'm going to leave out some hair to frame my face and then pick up a section on the left side of the part for my braid. I'm dividing this section into 3 smaller pieces and I'm going to be crossing the side strands over the middle strand to begin a French braid. So after the first stitch of the braid, I'm going to incorporate a new section of hair on both sides of the braid. And then I'm going to stop adding in hair to the top side of the braid and only bring in new pieces from along the hairline. So this will switch it to a lace style braid. So I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand and incorporating new sections of hair along the bottom side of the braid. And I'm going to be bringing in about 5 sections just until the braid reaches my left ear. And then once the braid reaches my ear, I'm going to go back over the braid and gently loosen the edges so it's wider. And then I'm just going to continue braiding the section a little bit further down without adding in any additional pieces. And then I'm going to go back over the braid and pull on the edges to make it wider. Now I'm going to divide off a section of hair on the right side of my head. So just starting at my ear and going up towards my crown, I'm going to combine this section of hair together with my braid and tie it together using a clear elastic band. And then on the second wrap, I'm going to pull the hair only a little ways through to create a loop. And then I'm just going to grab my scrunchie and tie it over the elastic band to finish off the style. For the twisted ponytail, I'm going to start by dividing off a section of hair to use for my twists. I'm not going to use all of my hair because I've noticed that when I do that, it makes it hard to balance the shape of the hairstyle. So I'm just going to divide off 2 sections of hair about where my ears are and bring this to the back of my head. Then using a hairband, I'm going to tie the 2 sections together and then create a gap in the hair right above the hairband. I'm going to flip the ponytail up and around the hairband so the 2 sides are twisted. And then I'm going to detail the hair a little bit by pulling on the sides of the twists, smoothing down the hair at my crown and spraying the style with some hairspray to smooth down any flyaways and combine the hair together. And now I'm going to gather the remaining hair along with the ponytail and tie this all together using a scrunchie. This will form the ponytail but still maintain the shape of the style without using all of the hair in the twist. It'll also create a smoother finish with the hair on the sides of my neck. And it's a super quick style and a fun way to upgrade a basic pony. For the last hairstyle, I'm going to start by splitting my hair into 2 sections since I'll be doing 2 buns. I'm going to tie off the hair on the left side to work with the hair on the right side first. So I'm going to gather all of the hair from the right side and brush it up to the crown of my head, placing it where I want my bun to sit. Then I'm going to grab a hairband and wrap it over the section of hair. On the last wrap of the elastic band, I'm going to pull the hair partway through to create a little loop. Then I'm going to take the ends from the ponytail and wrap them around the hairband a couple times. And then I'm going to tuck the ends back into the hairband to hold it in place. And then I'm going to grab my scrunchie and place it over the bun so it sits against my head. Now I'm going to take the hair from the left and repeat the same steps as the right side. So I'm going to brush all of the hair up to the crown of my head next to the first bun. And with a hairband, I'm going to wrap this over the section. And then on the last wrap of the elastic, I'm going to pull the hair partway through to create a loop again. Then I'm going to take the ends and wrap them around the hairband a couple times. And then tuck the ends back into the hairband underneath the bun to hold it in place. And then as a last step, I'm just going to grab my scrunchie and wrap it over the bun. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Let me know in the comment section which of the hairstyles was your favorite and whether you plan on recreating any of them. I had a lot of fun making this video. I usually have to be a little bit more creative when I have a bunch of hairstyles in one video. Make sure to like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads, and I will see you next time.